A very good morning students and welcome back in the online teaching of science. Students, we were there in the chapter number 13, Fun with Magnet, on the page number 128. So yesterday in our previous video we have done the activity 3 and this table I have given you in the homework. I hope that all of you have done the homework. So today we will start the activity 4. So let's start from the 13.2, from here, the poles of magnet. Okay, so let's begin our chapter. We observed that the iron filings, if they are present, see what they are telling, that in the soil or in the sand, if the iron particles are present, it's called a iron filings, stick to a magnet rubbed in the soil. See, when we are rubbing the, in the activity this one 3, we have done the same thing, right? We are rubbing the magnet in the soil or sand. So they are talking about that. Stick to a magnet rubbed in the soil. Did you observe anything special about the way they stick to the magnet? See what they are telling, that the iron filings, how they are sticking to the magnet. So they are telling us to observe that. Did you observe anything different how they are sticking to the magnet? So let's see in the activity 4, that was the special or a different thing while sticking to the magnet. Spread some iron filings on a sheet of paper. See what they are telling, that the iron particles spread into the sheet of paper, on a sheet of paper, right? Now place a bar magnet on this sheet. Now then after, you have to place a bar magnet on that sheet. What do you observe? Do the iron filings stick all over the magnet? Do you observe that more iron filings get attracted to some part of the magnet than other? See what they are telling, that after spreading the iron filing on the paper, we have to place the magnet over there and then we have to observe what, that on which side or on which part the iron filings are sticking more. Okay, see, you can see here that, let me show you. See here, the more iron filings are sticked compared to this one, and see in the middle nothing is there. Okay, so they are telling us to observe the such things. this one is the 13.7 figure. Okay, do you observe that more iron filings get attracted to some part of the magnet than the other? In the figure 13.7, see here in the figure 13.7, here the more iron filing is there compared to this one. Remove the iron filings sticking to the magnet and repeat the activity. See what they are telling, that now just remove that iron filing stick to the magnet and then after repeat the same activity again. Do you observe any change in the pattern with which the iron filings get attracted by the different part of the magnet? See what they are telling, that again after doing the same process again, we have to observe the magnet, which are the particles or iron filings are sticking again in the same position or in the same pattern or not. We have to observe that, or they are sticking to the different part of the magnet or either in the same part of the magnet, that we have to see. You can do this activity using the pin or iron nails in place of iron filings and also with the magnet of different shapes. See what they are telling, that this activity, there is no need of iron filing in this, but instead of that we can use the nail or a pins. Okay, so with the help of pins and iron nails you can complete this activity, and or either a different shapes of magnet also you can use to do this activity. See what was there, the next one, draw a diagram to show the way iron filing sticking to the magnet. Is your diagram similar to that shown in the figure 13.6? See what, here is a 13.6, this we have done yesterday, right? In one bar nothing is there, in some of the iron filings are sticked and in this one many of the iron filings have been sticked. Okay, so they are telling us to draw the diagram the same as we have shown in the 13.6, and then we will come to the conclusion that whether the iron filings are sticking in the same position or they are having in the different pole or that all. Okay, we find dwellings are attracted more towards the region close to two ends of the bar magnet. Yes, that's true, that the two ends of the bar magnet. See, this is the one end of the bar magnet and this is the another end of the bar magnet. And what we have observed that the between space is empty. Not all of the iron filings are sticking over here, but instead of that, the iron filings are sticking over the end of the pole, end of the magnet, right? Poles of the magnets are said to be near those ends. See what they are telling, that those two, this one, it's a two poles of the bar magnet, okay? Now, check for the location of the poles on those magnets using iron filings. Can you now mark the location of the poles in the kind of the magnet shown in the figure 13.4? See what they are telling, that the 13.4, where is the figure 13.4? Here it is. See what they are telling, they are telling to check out the magnet, and after checking the different types, different shapes of the magnet, now you have to identify the two poles of the magnet. See, here one pole is a, here one is a, here is a, in the shoe magnet, here. Okay, so those are the two poles of the different shapes of the magnet. Now, can you mark the location of the in the kind of the magnet shown in the figure 13.4 that we have done? Let us make such a direction finder for ourselves. See what they are telling, that now we have to make a direction for ourselves to find that things. See students, in this video we have learned what only the two poles of the magnet, okay? See here, this is the one end and this is the another end. This is the one pole of the magnet and this one is the another pole of the magnet. Okay? Nothing is there in this. So, and what they have done, they have just told us to, they have just given explanation about that, the to which pole, the which end the magnets are sticking, or the iron filings are sticking, or in the middle of it, it's sticking or not. That we have seen. Okay? So the remaining activity 5 we will complete in our next video, and we will stop it over here for today, okay? So that's all for the day, students. Have a good day.